Welcome to Inside the U, the ultimate adult hockey podcast. We are here.
We're here.
We are here.
I'm sad.
What's wrong, dude? Episode 12, huh? Right?
What's wrong? Should we wait till league updates to get into why you're sad, or is there other reasons?
Well, no. There's just, yeah. I mean, I guess we could wait, but
okay.
We'll cut to the chase real quick. No one here at the U table will be taking part in the playoffs.
Oh, yeah.
I told Steve before, I'm like, that's cool, because we're setting up for a huge fall comeback, both from the league perspective, from, you know, our playing perspective, you know. It's going to be a good fall. Let's put it that way.
We have to work. So,
yeah.
We're here to work.
Well, yeah. Actually, Larry won't be here.
At least I won't have to worry about missing a playoff game.
Yeah, exactly.
I won't be playing in any.
Yep. There you go.
First time.
Yeah.
First time for all of us.
I know. We've been in the finals.
Yeah. So we go deep. So,
I'm kind of used to it. She
said. So, yeah, you're used to taking a few weeks off.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, from playing.
Must be nice, dude.
From playing, yeah.
From playing, not working.
All right.
I could use it. Honestly.
All right, y'all. Welcome to Inside the U, the ultimate adult hockey podcast, where each week we're bringing insider topics, special guests, and slight entertainment from the world of adult hockey, along with discussions and updates around the Ultimate Adult Hockey League. Steve has already kicked off some of our updates. I'm Larry, joined as usual by UHL Commissioner Steve Vaines, temporary VP of U-Charities. He's come up in the world from intern to...
Temporary VP.
It goes both ways, okay? He's in line for a promotion, but he also could be cut when he goes on vacation next time.
Yeah, pretty true.
See, it goes both ways. It's temporary.
Yep.
So he's like on
probation. Could be good, could be bad.
Yeah. Trial period.
Yeah, he's
trial period.
So probational VP of U-Charities.
Let's go.
Jerry the Greek. And this week we have... Jerry, yeah, the Greek guy to my right here.
Wait, what am I in the U-Charities?
Your secretary.
Is it really?
I gotta look. He gave you something, but you're just on the board.
You're on the board, and I put you as secretary. Nice. So he's president on VP. I put you down as secretary. Right. So you got to take notes.
You're on the official official paperwork. So
yeah.
the whatever initial registration, whatever. This week we have a lot to get into. Recapping the All-Star game, breaking down the playoff picture, and selecting July's players of the month, plus plenty more. So before we do all that, I want to ask if you guys continue to drop comments, give us feedback, and share the show when you see fit. Quick reminder that something as small as sharing this episode can quite literally contribute to growing the UHL as a whole. Been a lot of comments recently. Appreciate you all. Yeah, a lot of good feedback.
Let's go.
From our guests, our guest hosts.
Yeah.
People are loving it.
Maybe one day we'll be able to do a Q&A.
Yeah, ASG was
get enough cues.
A lot of fun. Where I was going to go next was I wanted to touch base quickly on our All-Star game presented by DraftKings. Obviously, it was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it was fun.
I
had a great time. It was a great setup.
Yeah.
The intermission was long.
Yeah, the second one was.
Even the first one.
That's because there was a lot of guys.
A lot of shooters.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it was a lot of fun. Everybody seemed to have a great time.
It was like the tightest game in
All-Star history. There was a couple moments where it could have pretty tension with the overtime.
What the heck with the under, man? I went over.
Yeah, I went over.
It's an All-Star game.
It was 3-3.
I got that wrong.
3-3.
Oh, I have percentages of what people picked here. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah. 3-3 going into the third.
That's crazy for an All-Star game, man.
It is. The Kraken. You said Kraken. The Kraken faded off in the third.
Well, there was a couple opportunities. Like I said, Hunter had a couple chances, and then the 7-4, I think, was a little misleading because they scored a couple late, and it was just, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. So we had, like Jerry said, so it came in on the under. Only 15% of people picked the under.
Wow. Yeah, that's nuts.
There was a penalty. Most people were there. Will there be a goal in the first 5 minutes? This wasn't as misleading as I thought. 96% of people picked yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Will there be overtime? No. Hat trick? No. Most people picked yes. 70% picked yes.
The hat trick?
Yeah.
Yeah, I picked that.
Most assist total? Most people picked over. It was under. Most points total, under 5.5. People were on the right side there. Oh, the first goal, Buccaneers and Kraken, was pretty split. And the game winner was pretty split, too. Almost 50-50. So.
Cray-cray. Yeah.
I didn't realize they had all the percentages of the choices here.
The pool thing made it a lot of fun.
Oh, it was sick.
What was the percentage for Bobby Bascow over?
77%.
Over?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Hunter was actually at 74%.
For over?
Yeah.
The U community still believes in Bobby Bascow.
Yeah, and then Magnin and Gilletta, people were pretty split on him, 50-50. I guess because there wasn't a lot of goals this year. There was quite a few unders. Quite a few unders hit. Most points was under.
What about the shootout? Rusty shootout winner.
Oh, well, that's a good one.
Nobody picked the Raptors.
Oh, my God. We,
the nobody had.
Well, the Raptors are 0-10.
Yeah.
The correct answer, obviously, was the Raptors. 1.75% picked of 60. So
the guy that won. So Aaron, who won?
Probably. He picked himself.
Let's go. Himself. I hope he did. That's incredible.
How many people picked the Corn Stars?
Corn Stars at 26%.
Yeah, because I think I even said on here that Eisner was going to win it. Yeah. And he was down. He had like 10 chances to win it.
I know. That was ridiculous.
So did the one from Dusty Bush. The what's her name?
I forget. I don't have
way to go, dude.
I know. Colin?
Colin? No. Emily, right?
Emily? Or Melanie?
Oh, I was thinking Melanie Colin.
Yeah. No, yeah. I think it's Emily.
Emily?
She had a couple chances.
Yeah, most people picked Savage for highest save percentage. Our boy Carroll ended up taking that.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, Ryan played a great game, too. Yeah. And then Carroll just came in with about 3 minutes left in the second because there was not a whistle. I was trying to get a whistle for him and then had a shutout for the rest of the game. So
this is cool, man. I didn't realize they had all the percentage breakdowns here. That's awesome. Most people picked, obviously, Snap Fitness or Team 24/7 for their most points in the gold division. Looks like people picked the Bulldogs for silver. And then Moonshine for bronze plus. Mm-hmm. Chugs for bronze one. And then Sugarbush for bronze two. So that was where the most picks were. Nice. And they were actually correct too. So
cool.
That was cool. I didn't realize the percentage were out there. That's sick.
Yeah. A lot of fun.
Yeah, you can go check that out. If you join the pool, you can go look at it.
One of our scorekeepers took first place.
Yeah. Sick. Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was cool. Stay tuned for more on DraftKings.
Yes.
Any other closing thoughts on
ASG?
Spring, summer 24 ASG?
Yeah, I mean, we added a few things. Yeah. The tent, I think that was a cool thing to add.
Yeah, that was cool.
Tent.
Great.
The tent.
Great idea, Steve. We had the little putt-putt for the golf to advertise the golf a little bit. A lot of kids were playing that.
That was fun.
Dusty's new fit.
We'll get more into Dusty, the golf in a little bit here.
Dusty came out with a new fit. I think he had the crowd buzzing.
Yeah.
He did. I was reffing the game.
What's it like being on the ice seeing Dusty fly around?
Well, I saw him out there, right? And I'm like, okay. And then as I'm skating up the ice, but I'm trying to pay attention to the play. Yeah. So you can't like look in the crowd, like, you know, because something was going on that I had to look. But I heard the crowd going crazy and I'm like, what's he doing? So I kept like, I was like looking back at the thing, looking at Dusty. Like
trying
Dusty was pumping up. So Dusty had two shirts, right?
Okay.
And, you know, he split the crowd in half and he, you know, they were competing. The louder side got the shirts. Nice. So had him going.
Dusty's a natural.
There's always like a, it's so crazy. Like there's always like a full blown crowd.
There. Yeah.
Like yeah, there was a
Saturday night, you know?
And yeah, but here's the other thing.
And that was a lot for summer.
Yeah, I was about to say, exactly. I don't think we met the potential because of summer. A lot of people were on vacation. A lot of people that got chosen couldn't even come.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, we had, the shop was open. We had more Hawaiian shirts.
Hawaiian shirts.
We had,
So you have those shirts left over? I need them, by the way.
What?
I need the shirts.
Which ones?
The ones that weren't sold.
All of them?
No, just the ones that I want to wear.
Oh. Sure. Yes, I do have them.
Yeah.
I got a big, I fucking spill stuff on my shirts all the time. I made those white ones that are my favorite.
They're nice. And
I fucking have stains all over them. Yeah, those it lasted all of like three times.
It's always like the stupidest, like
coffee.
Yes. Yeah, like something I'm like on my way to work or something.
Yeah.
And a little tiny bit of coffee.
So you know what you do with those?
And it's like right here.
Yeah.
You know what you do with those shirts? You cut the sleeves off and use them for like yard work or going to the gym. Anyway. No sleeves, baby.
Stay tuned for a recap video of the All-Star game. Rob does a good job of capturing all that stuff, and it'll feel like you were there. We'll have a photo gallery up as well. And obviously, you know, it's something we do each season. Plan to get better and better each season, and stay tuned for that.
We've added a little something to
we already have some other things in mind for you know next season and you know all-star games to come. What
we're buzzing
nothing dude
what
no
Why are you laughing?
No, I'll tell you later.
Okay. What a weirdo, dude. All right. Anyway, summer showdown. Or so, whatever you have next.
So we got some things going on. So I want to explain why I'm wearing what I'm wearing. Okay. So in honor of the Olympics, because the Olympics is going on, and the motherland of Greece obviously started the Olympics, right? So we're just going to do the history of the games real quick and go back around 3,000 years.
This is what we're doing Greece. Summer showdown for.
Can you? No, because we're going to do that too. This is just a little lecture. We're just going to
let him cook. Let him cook.
All right. So sports contests organized at Olympia took place every 4 years and acquired the name Olympic Games, right? So we do not know exactly when they started, but the date of 776 BC is often cited in written sources. So Olympics goes back and... So I was watching a game this morning. Not that the Goomball Giannis played, beat the Aussies. So I was like, you know what? I got to wear his jerseys, put his kicks on, got the shoes on. You guys can't see that, but
he's a big LeBron guy. So how do you feel about that?
Who is
Giannis?
They're all like that because he's just in the league right now. He runs it, but
so you woke up today and watched Greek basketball.
I did, yeah.
Nice, dude.
Yeah, they were on at like 8 o'clock. It was a big. It was they lost their first two, so they needed this one. But Olympics, I put it on first thing in the morning. I put the Olympics on.
Yeah, I haven't been to.
I heard you recorded the ceremony, the beginning.
The weird dude. It was weird. I didn't get to see. I just saw highlights. So I didn't watch it because I think we were here.
There's a lot of shit going on.
Yeah, a lot of weird stuff going on with the boxer and this and that. Like that whole trend of whatever France is doing. But
typical. I feel like every time they get a chance, and they I say they, it? As in the these French? Huge media conglomerates, when they know the world's watching, they will do the weirdest shit they possibly can. Yeah, I think that's their goal.
They got an agenda.
But, well, yeah, they that's one thing, but they also
either way
are they want eyes, they want people talking about it. Yeah. Right?
I'd tell you my like real thoughts, but maybe for the casual podcast.
Yes. So either way, the Olympics is an amazing.
There's been a couple topics where we should subvert and then save it for that. But sorry, Derek.
We bring, Olympics brings the world together, right?
Did you wake up early and brush your hair this morning?
No, but does it look good? Thank you.
It does look good.
Oh, thank you.
It does.
All right, so my next bit, and we're going to stay on theme. So you know how we used to have Dusty's Brew of the Week, right? Well, just for today, in honor of the motherland, this bit is called the Summer Shot. What is a summer shot, you say? Well.
Summer shop or shot?
Shot.
Shot, okay.
Shot. What I got here is, hold up, come in, the legendary Greek liqueur ouzo.
Proud.
We are going to take a shot. Yes, we are.
Is this your surprise?
Hold on. Yeah. Isn't the games in Paris?
It is, but...
You're just making it all about...
Jerry's made it all about the Greeks. Making the Olympics about Greece.
Well, it is. That's why they come in...
Oh, yeah, it is.
They come in first every Olympics because, they create it. That's
why
you're
trying to kill me? You're trying to kill me on a Friday?
So Uzo is a video of Hitler tweaking at the Olympics because he's on meth.
Yeah.
He's like fucking...
Is it really?
Yeah.
So Uzo is a clear... And dry, made from grape must or grain that is distilled with spices and has
vodka?
An alcohol volume. No, it's like
it looks like vodka.
No, it's not. It's like a Zambuca type. It's a black licorice. We'll only do a little bit.
Well, halfy.
Yeah, a little halfy.
Good morning.
So we got the
Steve is so bad at you right now.
The UHL shot glasses from Carol gave
Shout
us
these. To KK.
Right? Yeah. KK gave us this as a gift for having him on. And
KK, I stopped at KK's house last night.
Oh yeah.
He gave me a Lightning McQueen like ride on car.
Oh, nice! Cool.
For Luca, that he.
What do you attach this thing to?
It's like a Power Wheels.
Yep, battery powered.
Oh, you said ride on car. I thought I was thinking.
Yeah, like something. Luca gets in it and rides it around.
I thought you looked like you were attaching it to something. Mm-mm. Like your.
No,
I don't fucking know, dude. It's the way you described it.
Yeah, my bad.
All right, the summer shot, guys. Just take a little.
Sorry,
bit.
Sorry, the shot hit me.
Cheers.
Dude, it smells like fucking black licorice.
I literally just said that.
Smells like Greeks.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not drinking it, but...
Just like have a little smell. Sip. Just have a little sip.
Yep.
Delicious.
Yeah, it's good.
It's actually really good.
Yeah, it is good.
It's like black licorice.
You didn't even take it. So this actually backfired because I thought we were going to have lunch first. Yeah. Now all of us have an empty stomach.
Yeah.
But, so if you guys have never had it, it's delicious.
It's disgusting.
No, it's not. It's very good. So,
if you like black licorice,
yeah,
licorice. Yeah. I said it.
It like is good. Spelled. If you, yeah, if that's your.
That's exactly what it smells like. And I remember one time when I was a kid, I Because I used to like Twizzlers, you know?
Yeah.
And then I got like the regular licorice and I was like, this is gonna be great. Yeah. And I remember like trying to peel it off my tongue, dude. It's like scrape, like it tastes so bad.
Yeah. Twizzlers, so bad. Dude. Overrated. Mm-hmm. Licorice overrated.
Twizzlers, dude?
No, like, Twizzlers are pretty good.
Twizzlers are good, dude.
Like you're gonna get a pack of candy and you're gonna get a pack of Twizzlers.
Just have a little
that's what you're gonna do.
Mm-hmm. Yo, have a little sip. A little sip.
No.
Why?
Oh, I thought he tasted it already.
No, he didn't. He was joking.
It tastes like
black. I definitely, so I have, like, my stomach can't handle hard liquor. And if I do it on an empty stomach, like, I'm going to be sick.
You're going to die?
Yeah.
Take a sip.
No.
I'm just kidding. All right. So that was just a little nod to the Olympics.
Summer shot.
Yeah, summer shot. So why not, right?
When was the gladiator stuff?
That was.
They should make that an Olympic.
That was Rome. That was Rome, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Cool. Anyway, all right, hit the button. Let's go. Beautiful. Don't crown a tie for a summer showdown and all this family feud style competition between the two of you. I'll be your host, and the loser of the two of you will have to do something that the U community will vote on. But the most important thing about this bit, which I love, and I say it every time, the loser won't be me. Don't care what you say. So
I'm
we have
positive before every summer showdown. You try to throw me off somehow, dude.
Well, so I actually did the shot. So
nice,
yeah.
Nice.
So maybe it'll.
So perhaps.
Oh, it keeps going.
It keeps going.
Oh, you have the whole thing. I love it.
It keeps going.
All right. So we have
one in it first.
So we have 3 weeks left until playoffs start. So we are going to have three rounds. We're changing it up of fast money, rapid questions with the top five. Most popular answers are weighted with points. Person with the most points will be awarded. This round is worth 2 points to their total score.
So it's like at the end when they do, when they're standing there two with like Steve Harvey.
Yes.
Total score?
Yes. So it is 7-4.
Whoa, whoa, whoa,
We have three rounds weighted for 2 points. So whoever has the most points at the end of
it. Is this the finale?
Yeah, this is the finale. This is the final stretch, baby. This is the playoff.
This is the last one time we're doing this?
Three.
We have three rounds. Oh, okay.
So we have 3 weeks left.
Three of the same thing.
Yeah, but different questions.
So
yes.
But the next 3 weeks are worth two.
Yes.
Okay, so, all right, I got you.
So do we have to, like, one of us has to leave?
Yes. So you have, Jesus. So let me just give you the.
I got to get another round of beers anyway.
So. Yeah. Okay. All right, so this is what we're going to do. So you have 30 seconds to answer the questions, and the first answer you say will count. All right.
Can I pass?
No. Well, yeah, yes. You can pass and then come back to it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the timer.
This is fun.
Yep. So
Steve's so mad. He doesn't want to
have fun. I got a timer right here. Once it hits, you'll hear that. You got to stop. So I'm going to type them in and read them as fast as I can. I'll do my best.
And you're going to if they say the same thing?
No. So here's why it's different, because they're all weighted the same. You guys can say the same answer. They're just the scores are right here. So I went to a Family Feud website, right? And I have random questions.
I thought when you say the same thing as somebody else.
That's when you're on the same team.
Yeah, you're on the same
team. But you guys are going against each other. So whoever has the total amount of points.
I gotcha.
All right.
I'll learn this eventually.
Yeah.
I should probably watch one of the shows.
If you go on the Roku, do you have Roku at all? Uh-uh. Roku TV just has a free Family Feud channel. 24 hours a day. Sure. Family Feud.
Yeah. And it's funny because they had like three or four hosts.
My dad watches it a lot.
Yeah, I think it was like Monty Hall was one. Louis Anderson was another. And Steve Harvey are the three that I know. But yeah.
Well, I'll call like my grandma and ask her.
Yeah.
There you go. Well, the original guy was Richard Dawson.
Oh, Richard Dawson. That's who it was. Yes. Monty Hall did.
He knows everything about Family Feud now, dude.
Yeah. Monty Hall was Let's Make a Deal in the other one. Yeah. All right. So, Larry, if you don't mind leaving the room.
Oh, so I am first. Okay.
Yes.
I am
first. Shut the door and stay out there, and we will, we'll shoot you a text or call you. And then you come back in.
It's risky.
No, it's not. Just get out there. All right.
Okay. This is just all an elaborate scheme to talk shit on Larry when he leaves.
Yes. Yeah. He's actually getting fired. This is not me. All right. All right. Are you ready?
I guess. Do I have to do this at all?
No. You just answer. So when it comes to your head, just answer it and I'll type it in.
What's the questions?
They're random. Random questions.
The
good thing is,
full disclosure.
Yeah,
I might say something stupid because the first thing that usually comes to my mind is something stupid.
But you have 30 seconds and it's only 5 questions, so you have some time.
All right.
And the good thing is, you don't have to ever leave the room. You can stay here because
I'm nervous, dude.
Yeah, it's kind of exciting.
All right.
Ready?
Sure.
Here we go. All right. Name a popular color for a car.
Red.
All right. Name a fruit you might find in a smoothie.
Banana. Wait, fuck. Is banana, it's kind of, that's a debate.
No, dude, no, dude, you did it. Come Name on. Something you do when you wake up in the morning.
Brush your teeth.
Okay. Name a popular pizza topping.
Pepperoni.
Okay. And name a sport played without a ball. Time's up.
Oh, shit, dude. Wait, what the fuck?
Yeah, name a sport played without a ball. There's a lot.
What's a sport?
All right, call Larry.
Well, now I need to know the answer. Now I feel like I got to itch.
No, I'll scratch. Do it at the end.
God damn it,
I'll dude. Do it at the end.
All right, Larry.
Just call him. Are you going to do that? All right, so I will I'll do the tally at the end, right? Everything. He's pissed.
I was waiting for a text. I'm like,
yeah.
Hopefully I get it.
He's mad right now.
You didn't get so, it?
No, the last question, you, I couldn't think of one. But you, to be fair, he said I was timed up, but he took like 10 seconds to fucking ask me the damn question. He was writing the answers as he was doing it.
Yeah,
he
but
lost at least 5 seconds.
Dude, I did. I went quick.
You lost me at least 5 seconds.
No, you're good.
Did he tell you the it topic beforehand?
It shouldn't have been timed. It shouldn't have been timed.
Or is there multiple topics? Or?
It's random.
It's random.
It shouldn't have been timed. Said, okay.
No, it shouldn't have been timed.
All right. Well, this is first round. If we'll debate it next time.
If you're going to write the answers as you go, you probably can't time it.
Why? I was doing because it quick.
You were like, and then you ask a question. It. Then you type it, ask a question.
No, we're good. All right.
Whatever.
Ready?
Better hit that fucking thing. All you right, better ready? Take just as long.
I am. I will.
All right. I'm ready.
All right. You ready?
Yep.
All right. Name a popular color for a car.
Red.
All right. Name a fruit you might find in a smoothie.
Strawberry.
Name something you do when you wake up in the morning.
Brush your teeth.
You guys are the same. Name a popular pizza topic.
Pepperoni.
Let's go. And name a sport played without a ball.
Hockey.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. That's why I thought that was funny. Because you completely botched that.
Dude, look on his face right there. Oh, my God.
So I'll tell you right now that Larry won.
Woo! Yeah, because he got one of the questions.
Yeah, but he got more number one. All right.
God, yeah. My brain went fucking blank, that was dude. Funny. I started thinking
that's
about,
the worst, dude.
I didn't have time, so I was in my mind, I'm rolling through all the sports in my head, and I went baseball, football, basketball, tennis, and I didn't get to the fucking one.
Yikes, I love dude. That you went tennis before hockey.
I don't, well, shut up, dude.
Okay. So
he said, oh my God.
All right. Ready? So
name I knew it was going to be embarrassing.
Name of the popular car, right?
Yeah.
You both said red, which is worth 27 points, but that is the number two answer.
I don't know why I said fucking red.
The number one
black
is black.
Yeah, but I don't would know be, why I said red.
It is for 34 points. Name a fruit you might find in a smoothie. Banana was number two.
Strawberry banana smoothie.
Strawberry was number one.
Bang, bang.
Blueberry, mango, pineapple. All right. Name something you do when you wake up in the morning. You both got the number one answer with brush your teeth or 30 points. The next one is stretch, yawn, check your phone, use the bathroom. Beautiful.
I was going to say drink coffee, so I'm glad I didn't say that.
All right. Number four, you both said, which is name a popular pizza topping. You both said pepperoni.
Pepperoni.
Worth 45 points. Then there's cheese, sausage, mushrooms, and onions. And name a sport played without a ball. Hockey is number one, which you got. Boom. Swimming, track and field, gymnastics, and wrestling. So Larry takes it. Yep. The first one worth 2 points. Fair. But I think you
it's over.
Might. Yeah, it's over.
You should have told me that before we started, dude.
Because then there's nine. Yeah, you got it's 9-4. The most you can get is 8. So he wins. Yeah.
We could figure out a way to make it stretch out a little bit.
Can we do 3 points for the next one?
We could do 3 and then 4. How about that?
Let's go.
Just keep giving him a chance. Just keep giving him a chance. I'm down with that.
So honestly. That's it. Hit it, baby.
I'm having fun.
There you go.
Why not hockey related, though?
Because this was fun.
It was. I liked it. I enjoyed it.
I enjoyed it. Was a little trivial. Because the first 12 weeks were hockey, and you complained about every single one of them. So
they weren't. They weren't hockey, and I complained that it wasn't hockey.
Yes, it were.
It was UHL, NHL.
Yeah. UHL, NHL.
Was last week.
All hockey. Mm-mm. What, last week?
Yeah.
What did I do last
you
week?
You won last week. You did the medieval.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you did win. You got them all. So, yeah, just medieval. So that was the one because of our guest.
Which was very impressive, by the way.
It was very impressive.
Nice job.
I did give him a hint, though.
Yeah, you did.
I did give him a hint. So that's Summer Showdown.
No, Steve, don't.
I'm not a big game show.
I'm the bit champion. So
yes.
Just you ended up unfortunately, yeah. going off again. If
he is, so that's
if it was Jerry, he would have lost too.
So. I'm not a quick thinker. Yeah. I'm like a calculated.
Mm, fair. All right, so that's fast money, rapid.
Or slow.
Rapid question.
You know?
You feel slow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, again, I'll get the right answer eventually.
Or maybe if you took took a shot of Uzo, you'd stop overthinking and just hit it.
That's a fair point. I just ran out of time, dude.
You ran out of time.
You thought tennis before hockey.
No, I didn't. I'm just saying in my mind, I was just step by step going through all the sports. I just didn't have it. You were like done, and I was like, fuck, and I didn't get to that.
So either way, even if you said hockey, you would have lost because he had more number ones.
Yeah.
With the strawberry.
So strawberry, though.
Strawberry smoothie.
Banana. I said strawberry, and I'm like, why didn't I say banana? But
aren't you glad I didn't say banana?
Yeah.
Good joke.
I don't like strawberries.
Yeah.
Strawberries. Oh, you don't like strawberries. Okay. So
strawberry is
allergic to some degree. If I eat, like, I ate like two strawberries once and I like broke out in hives.
Wow. You said red too? I don't even know why I said red.
I'm like,
because
it stands out, right?
Yeah, but black was number one. White, blue, silver.
Racist.
I would never even buy a red car, personally.
No. Me neither. No. Well, I liked red cars.
Yeah.
And then Brie got me the colorblind correction glasses.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah.
And I put them on, and I was looking around. It's all right. And then I see a red car, and I'm like, bro. That is so bright.
Really?
Depends on the red, too.
I was like, how much attention do you need?
Yeah.
Like, that is, like, you're just trying to stand out that much.
Well, you know, like, the statistic is they get the most tickets because...
Yeah, fucking A. It's like a fucking highlighter rolling down. Right, it's so bright. Yep. And I was, like, blown away by how bright it was.
Yeah.
All right. Well, those are the bits that I got for today.
That's all you got?
Hope you guys had fun.
I had a lot of fun.
Good.
You're doing great,
Jerry. We took a shot. We got some Uzo in us. We learned a little bit about the history of the Olympics. We're representing Greece. Yeah. Elada. Oh, the only thing I didn't tell you, which I thought would have been cool.
I'd love to go there.
Larry's going.
Just booked hotel
You know how when you toast.
You just see the pictures.
In Greek, you say stini yassas, which it means to your health, which is ironic because you're drinking something detrimental to your health.
It's detrimental to your health over a long
time. Yeah, but mental health.
Oh, yeah. There you go. So you say "stimi yasas" and you take a sip.
It's different.
Everywhere. So to your health, yeah.
They do drink to health.
Celebrate your health.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's to you guys. That's the only thing I forgot to tell you guys.
Yeah, I forget what I was gonna say.
Damn it!
Oh,
hungry.
Now you booked your hotel.
I did. I wasn't gonna talk about that though. What I was gonna talk about was something coming up very soon.
Let's go.
The UHL events.
Yes.
Is presenting. Ooh. In combination with U-Charities, U-Golf Outing.
A lot of U's. So, yeah, U-Charities is, we're tying it in. So, here's our thought process. We do a lot for the community, right? With a lot for the league, a lot for the players.
Yeah.
And what we want to do is extend it as much as possible to help those in need.
Right.
So, we will be moving forward tying U-Charities to a lot of our events.
A lot of our one-day events.
Yeah, a lot of our one-day events, our one-offs, in order to just try to help as much as possible and give back as much as possible, right?
Yep.
So that way, you know, everybody feels good about, you know, coming too. So you come, you have a good time, and you're supporting a great cause.
Well, the reason we do events to begin with is to kind of bring...
Yeah, the community together.
Our little community together.
Yeah. So our thought is to take one further. So the events that we're thinking, obviously the golf outing, like we just said, our all-star games, and obviously everybody is familiar with Dusty Claws, which is our toy drive that we do in December.
Yep. So without getting too sidetracked, coming up September 16th is our second annual U-Golf outing. Going forward, it's for U-Charities. It's going to be at Valley Brook Country Club. Yep. 18-hole golf tournament with contests, giveaways, food, beverages, cocktails, cocktail reception. It's going to be a 12 p.m. start time.
Yep, 11 p.m. registration, which means what at 11 p.m.?
11 a.m.
11 a.m., sorry. What happens at 11 a.m.?
Crack and brews.
Let's go!
And hit the driving range.
Yeah, you could
hit the driving perhaps range. The putting green if you need green, to get your putting going motion going.
Yeah, 11 a.m., you start drinking. Register, start drinking. It's open for you guys.
Right, so that's September 16th. It is a Monday. Yes. Keep mark that on your calendars. Going to be a lot of fun. We have a ridiculous amount of things planned. I don't even think I can rattle it off the top of my head right now, but
I mean, it's your standard. Listen, we're going to have a lot of prizes, a lot of raffles for the dinner,
yeah.
which is after which the open bar is still open through dinner. We have the on-course competitions. We have the putting contest, which we're going to throw some new things. There might even be a little guest. that we're working on.
Yeah, Adam Sandler.
Yes, absolutely.
We got to talk about that because what was suggested to us
yep.
made me think that perhaps we should bring our own guest.
Possibly.
You know what I mean?
It's possible.
We'll talk about that.
Yes.
Either way, DraftKings will be a part of it. We'll do, like you said,
yeah.
Regular contests and competitions, regular golf outing stuff. And, you know, last year was a lot of fun. You can mm-hmm. check out the recap video. I'll link that in the description here. Registrations are open for our foursomes. There are sponsorship opportunities available on the website at that same page. There's going to be more coming there. And if you have any questions, you know, reach out to us.
Yeah, you know what's funny about this one, this event? For once, you guys, you don't give me a hard time about this, but this is the only event that it's actually true. There will be glizzies.
Hot dogs?
There will be hot dogs,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah, but we promised unlimited hot dogs.
Yeah, you get one. You get a hot dog ticket for lunch
but you
can, before you go but out.
You could, if you don't want a hot dog, you can collect. You know,
everybody else's, and yeah. then you have unlimited.
Oh, yeah.
That's it. Make friends.
Make trade some trades.
Yeah, trade a beer. Yeah. Go to the bar, get a beer, and trade it for the hot dog ticket. Yeah.
Nice.
Let's go.
Yeah, we'll do.
Whoever 50. Can eat the most hot dogs at the golf outing wins.
All right, stop making up things. No, that's not true.
Should yeah, so, we, yeah, should we put that on the pool?
yeah.
Most glizzies over under.
So we'll do a 50-50. We'll do what's the PC we'll name for the basket raffle?
Yeah, it's
the market told me it. It's yeah, something weird now. It used to be Chinese
tricky auction. Tricky tray.
Oh,
it's a I tricky had to say tray.
Chinese auction.
Yeah, you said Chinese.
How dare you?
It's a tricky tray. It's basically you buy tickets, you put it in a basket, and we already have committed. We usually get Flyers tickets. We got Sixers tickets.
Yeah.
We're going to have a box of Howie stuff. We're going to have Quench stuff. We're going to have maybe a DraftKings bundle thing yeah. going. That's just the stuff that we got right now.
Either way, you guys are familiar with our yeah. DraftKings pool for the All-Star game. We have more ridiculous prizes and opportunities mm-hmm. that are in the yes. works for this outing. So, like well, I said, uhhockey.com/golf. We hope you join us.
We have something else coming up in between. Now and
we do.
We do. CFC.
Baby. Checking for charity. Team UHL will be
yes.
representing U-Charities
yep.
At Checking for Charity Tournament. Come hang out with us. It's August 9th through the 11th. Saturday should be fun.
Yeah, I imagine we'll see.
So depending on where the games are, we will be posting up. We'll put the tent up. Infamous tent that I was talking about earlier.
Maybe we'll do some giveaways.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe we could do a basket.
I don't know. I just want to make Jerry do things.
Sounds like an event.
Just trying to get Jerry adding
hot dogs.
That's actually not a bad idea. You know what I will do?
Hot dog roller?
Hot dogs and beers?
Hot dogs. We'll do, maybe we could grill. I don't know. But what we will do is have a basket and you can come sign your name up and we will pull it and, you know, give you a call.
So I'm down for that.
You should do like a donate to U-Charities.
Yes.
Yeah.
Buy a ticket.
Option.
Yeah. You can buy a ticket and you win a cool. So we'll throw in. So you know what we'll do? We'll throw in a lot of stuff that from the ASG. So we'll maybe throw in a Hawaiian shirt.
Yeah.
A regular shirt. A tank top. A couple pucks. Koozies. All that good stuff. So we'll have a lot of you swag.
Sweet. I like this. You guys basket. Got a little peel behind the curtain there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So stop by our tent and for Checking for Charity and sign up. Maybe give a little donation for our charity and yeah. everything.
And have a beer yeah. with us because we're going to be drinking.
So we
that's yeah. what Checking for Charity is all about.
Yeah, I had a
yep.
I had a prior plan being set, and we were trying to like make it work during that weekend. I'm like, nah, I don't want to have to worry about anything else. I just want to be immersed in the tournament.
Yeah, it'll yes. be fun.
I expect to win.
So that's on Saturday the 10th because it's 9:10 and 11.
Saturday right? the 10th, and yep. we will be posted up where our second game is, right?
Correct.
That makes sense? I think that's a good plan. Sense. Yeah.
Hopefully.
I've asked to be at Hollidale for all three games so we can make
that it That would simple. Be
ideal. You know.
That'd be ideal.
Mm-hmm. It'll be great.
Cool. Yeah. Well, so a couple things coming up, but let's get into our league updates here. If you're ready to go there, Commission, I know you're doing your
prep. I was about to say, Steve actually has to work now.
I know.
Well, he was preparing. When we got here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With attitude, though, but he was preparing.
I can't believe I got to do this.
I know.
Can you guys leave me alone?
I wish if anybody wants to do this for me, please Please feel free.
Look how angry he is. He's miserable. He's miserable just even going through the paperwork.
He's miserable, but he just put out a good opportunity. So reach out. Let us know if you want to do some league updates for us. Yeah,
write some summaries for me so I can just read them all.
I feel like Santoro will do that, dude.
I know.
Bogger was good, man.
Bogger did excellent.
Bogger was good.
It was only Rusty preview, though, which he's very intimate with.
Yes, but he's in bronze, too.
He is in bronze.
So he can do that, and he's familiar with the league. He's in tune with the U.
Well, right. I never doubted you, buddy.
So, we will loop back to Friday, July 26th. JMCC Auto played Narwhals. JMCC Auto jumped out to a 5-goal lead. We have a interesting score, 10-3. JMCC Auto beat Narwhals. We have two goal scorers in that game for the JMCC Auto. What?
That's it?
5 goals for Eamon Hall.
Go, Eamon.
Big guy, funny guy.
Sheesh.
Bit of a jokester. 5 goals from Ian Carroll. So all 10 goals Ian for Carroll, James Ciardo came from 2 people. Yes, Ian Carroll, all-star. Then we had the South Jersey Sugar Bush play the Chuggernauts. It was back and forth the entire game.
Yep.
It was 6-6 with 5 minutes left, 7-7 with 2.5 minutes left. And then South Jersey Sugar Bush get the shootout win. So they went through overtime, which blows my mind.
Yeah.
Playing 3-on-3 overtime for someone not to score is nuts.
Well, it's only 5 minutes.
I know, but like, man, rarely do we go to shootout.
It's very rare.
It's very rare.
It's very rare. Yes. But, you know.
Usually it's and if anything, like within the first minute or two.
It goes quick, right?
It goes quick, yeah. So, Tropics play Shaka's Breath.
You can't say without doing that.
I know.
Shaka's Breath.
Tropics jumped out to a 4-1 lead. Shaka's claw back to make it 4-3, but it's not enough. Chris Kirchner scores in the late third period to make it 5-3, and the Tropics come out with a win.
Shaka's were hanging around in that game, eh?
Yeah. We had a little rusty action on Friday as well. Wolves jump out to a 4-1 lead over the Shell Shaka's. In Shaka's fashion, just like the last game, they make it 4-3, but Matt Eichmann scores to make it 5-3 with 2 minutes and 30 seconds left.
Yo, Matty.
It's a big win for the Wolves.
Friend of the U.
Hanging around.
Matty Ice.
The Wolves are hanging around. Huh?
Hanging around. Barely. We'll talk about that more.
I was about to say, do they have a chance?
They do. It's very small. We'll talk about it more, though.
Yes. And then Hawks Bronze play the Plugs Hockey Club. Hawks Bronze playing for nothing. like on the other Hawks.
Playing spoiler. Plugs are on the fence.
And then in typical spoiler fashion, the Hawks win in overtime.
Wow.
Cody Sherman scores in overtime to get the 6-5 win over the Plugs. The Veritas Centers played the Knights. Both all-stars, the Magnin brothers, Kevin and Chris, they combined for 9 points.
Shoot.
But Luke Veit, his 2 goals get the win in a 10-7 win over the Knights Veritas. For the Senators.
Let's go.
Yes.
Quiet team this season, but Bronze Plus is very competitive. So
yes. Sunday, July 28th.
Sunday.
Rusty Wolves are back at it against the South Jersey Corn Stars. Rusty Wolves win 3-2.
Yo, they are coming.
They're making a push.
They're howling.
Like I said.
Woo.
Like I said.
Yes.
Big wins.
Go Wolves. All right. So Narwhals played Shell Shaka's. Narwhals are what, sitting in second?
Narwhals are surprisingly, yeah.
We have a funny scenario that happened in the Rusty playoff picture. We'll talk about that in a minute. But yeah, Narwhals jumped up to second place.
They're doing
very
really
close.
Well.
The top five are very, very close.
They played the Shell Shaka's. They took control early in a 6-3 win.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So another game without Jerry and Larry, the Dusty Beavers play the South Jersey Raptors. Beavers jumped to a 6-0 lead.
To be fair,
without
Jerry. To be fair, we had our.
To be fair,
all-star game the day before, so we were.
Don't use that excuse. I don't.
Why weren't you there?
I don't claim that excuse. I was actually sitting at my desk, and I'm like, I can't make it tonight.
Oh, see, I was actually sitting on the beach, and I'm like, I can't make it tonight. So
some captain. All right.
Well, isn't that why you have assistant captains, alternate captains?
No.
Yes, it is.
No.
Listen.
I left it up to Bogger, and he did a great job.
Yeah, no. You should be there. Especially, captain, you should be working those skates.
Can I tell you? Yeah, after running into the boards.
Yes. Okay.
here's a scenario, though. I was planning on making it, and then we hit summer traffic.
No, you weren't.
No, we were. So, I hit traffic.
So despite some slander,
yeah.
When I broke my wrist, was I not at every Hawks game?
Oh my God.
I was at every Hawks game.
I think you were.
Right, I was. I was a bench boss.
Okay.
All right. So captain shows up no matter what. Lead by example.
I do lead by example. That's why I went in seventh place.
You lead.
Yeah, literally.
Yes.
All right. I was not there.
So, Moose Hockey played the Yetis despite a Carroll snipe. Carroll's got a shot.
Dude, what does he score every game, dude?
He does every game. What and the it's fuck? A, it's an absolute snipe every time.
Jeez.
And no. This one was actually, so he had a snipe. This one was a, he came across left to right and get a little backhand going left to right.
Who is this guy?
Carroll.
Yeah, I know.
Are the chicken tendies going to be for real?
I think they're going to be good, honestly. Yo.
Who do they got, though?
Mark.
Everybody. Rienzi,
Carol.
Santora. Wait, Mark's coming back for the chicken tendies?
Yeah.
He has to.
Okay.
They're going to be pretty good.
They got Brian Leeds. He's going to play out, right? I would assume.
Yeah, I would think so.
Yeah. But are the corn stars? That's like half the corn stars. Are they going to have enough players?
I don't know. So, Carol gets a goal, but...
Okay, okay.
Frankie James gets the game
winning
goal.
Frankie James!
Yo,
game winner?
I think he was making up for Saturday.
Yeah.
I think he was a little disappointed with his Saturday performance.
He had to show up.
Yeah, he had the net one. Huh? He had to give the crown up.
Yeah.
So shout out to Frankie. You know, he showed up. He's a showman. Let's be honest.
He is.
And
I was pulling for
let's
him.
Let's be honest.
I was pulling for him just because of how much of a showman he is.
Yeah. It was fun. He's fun. He's fun, man. And
I would much rather him, like, because he talked a lot of shit. And I'm like, we'll talk that shit. And
he did. But sometimes it doesn't work out.
And then he missed the first one. I'm like, oh.
He was in good spirits. But that goes back to why
a lot of pressure.
But that goes back to why the first shot is weighted 2 points. It's very important.
I think it should be reversed.
How?
No,
warm,
no.
You get some under your
no, yeah, but that's you, exactly yeah, you why. Score one cold. It's worth more.
It's harder. So that's why it's worth more. Man. So you get that first one, then people get cooking.
Especially they're not going out warming up either. They're just
at
fucking,
all. No, not even skating or anything. They're getting dressed behind a curtain, going out.
Yeah.
Getting announced and then going in front of, you know, all 35 people out there. Mm. No. It was. I know. I'm kidding. We had a
shut
good,
up, dude.
Let's roll here.
Shop. We had about 70 people. It was
next
good.
Game. Next game was a big
people.
One. Hundred, Steve.
Hundreds of people.
Rain City Gold played Hawks Gold. I'll let Larry comment. That's what my notes say. Larry comment.
Larry comment. You worked hard on that one.
This is gonna sound so sad, but we usually make it a game for like a period.
Wow.
And then once, because we always have a short bench.
Yeah,
Rain City's very good, very talented. They have more guys than us.
Something tells me DeMarco isn't.
He actually was not there for that game.
And I'm not saying his game on the ice. I'm saying the reason why you're short all the time.
Well, I mean, in his defense, we rostered a full lineup,
and they just don't show up.
Having a hard time getting guys to show up.
Why are the gold guys divas, man? Why are they all divas?
They're all divas. They're all divas.
I mean, if you look at our goal differential, we've been getting our ass kicked on a weekly basis. So it's like.
Yeah, but you're for it. Listen,
but did they your pay? First year. They paid?
Talk to DeMarco.
And they paid and don't show up. Must be nice, dude.
Yeah.
That's like Jerry, dude.
So, like I said, we're competitive for a little bit and then, you know. Something sneaks in. Not sneaks in, but,
Well, they lost by 10.
Yeah.
So, the Blue Chew Bulldogs played Militia. That was forfeit. Oh. So, Militia, Jeff Sporer, their captain, was not very happy. He's on vacation, and they couldn't get a team together.
Oh.
Yeah. See?
Are they? Well,
true
are they,
captain, dude.
He was. He's on vacation, worried about getting a roster out there.
Yeah. Wait. Who's this Militia?
I'm like Jerry.
Yep.
They're not even but they're not Jerry even playoff even contention, though.
Night's Watch played Team 24/7. So Alec Myers, he's good.
Yes.
Good player. Yes. Scores in overtime to beat 24/7. 24/7 a little short, at least short of their superstar guys, but still, they get a point. That pretty much solidified the
I got a little breakdown on
the lineup and the matchup.
Okay,
the semi's going to be pretty insane.
I was about to say, can we talk about Rain City Gold versus 24/7?
We will. Armada played Chill. Chill get the 10-2 win. We had our buddy of the show, John Bjornson, gets two goals. Sister, Sonya, gets three assists in that game.
Oh, three assists. Okay.
Very good. So next game, Rain City played the Whale Watchers. We had Kyle Young had a goal and four assists. 5-0 Rain City.
Let's go KY.
So this is a, kind of like a back and forth game. It was 5-0 Rain City, but the Whale Watchers eventually get it as close as 8-7.
Wow.
And then Christian and Sweeney gets the game winning goal to win 9-7.
Sweeney. Yes. Shout out to Kyle Young and Ross turning up in both divisions.
They are. Ross seems to have found his game.
I was about to say, Ross has stepped it up the last couple games. So it started with game of the week. He had a Hattie, which was nice. Mm-hmm. And then I seen the last couple games for silver and gold. He's been
playing very well.
He's been buzzing.
Ross. Moonshine played the Otters. It was 2-2 going into the third, and Stephen Linville scores to make it 3-2. I think Moonshine ended up getting a later goal, and then John Bjornson again with the game-winning goal.
Let's go, John.
He's going off a high off the inside of the year.
All right, John. Dude. Steve Linville had a good back-to-back this week, too.
Yeah. Come on our podcast, and you win a couple games. And
score I feel a few like goals. Linville's always in the mix.
Very valuable player for the Otters.
Really is. He is very much. So, the Hawks played the South Jersey Barracudas. Hawks go up 5-2. Almost blew it. Still eliminated. But win 5-4.
Suck it, Randazzo.
Yeah. So Hawks get the win. Come on, actually, dude. Have been playing very well. Just some hiccups throughout the season.
I say it came to a head over a span of two games.
It did. Yeah.
Night's Watch, we fought back to make OT. Lost an OT. Militia, we gave up a massive lead.
Yes.
To go to OT. And then lost an OT.
And then, but early in the season, we had games where we were winning, going to third, and lost as well.
Yeah, but
against Malty Ducks, which would have made a big difference.
I don't even remember those games. All I remember is those OT games.
We were winning.
That was the pivotal point, in my opinion.
We were winning by quite a bit. Yeah. What really put the nail in the coffin for the Hawks was Malty Ducks playing Night's Watch Silver. We're kind of scoreboard watching, and we see Night's Watch are winning 5-1 after the first.
Yep.
And we're like, oh. Woo! Let's go. We're still alive. they erase a 5-1 deficit. Adam Cantiello scores to tie it, and then they win.
What the hell with Malty Ducks, dude? I'm rooting for them now.
I honestly am, too.
Yeah.
They win in the shootout in the fifth round. Mitchell Oliveto scores in the fifth round.
Let's go, Malty.
To win the game, which is insane.
Sounds like our intermission shootout.
I know.
Mo Oliveto.
Paisanos. Played the Knights in a game very important for the Knights. Kevin Magnus scores for the Knights, but it's not enough as the Paisanos win 3-2 in regulation.
There you go.
Otters played the Koopas. Kevin McCafferty scores 3 points in a 9-3 win over the Koopas.
And again, Stephen Linville, 2 goals in back-to-back games.
He is.
Shout out.
Very good.
Told you.
So, the man. Veritas Senators. Sorry.
Jeez, you are feeling it today, huh?
Well, I don't have any food in me. I'm hungry.
Hungies.
Veritas Senators played Moonshine. Zach Candelore scores 2 goals and 3 assists. 5 points in a 12-7 win over the Sens. Zach, congrats, buddy.
Bobby Orr of you.
Yeah.
That's what they call him.
Is that it?
He commented that on the
post game. He does play defense, right?
Yes, he does.
All right. So, next game, JMCC Auto played Cheap Hockey. Our guy, Eamon Hall, continues his goal-scoring streak because he had 5 goals in the game before.
Eamon Hall.
He gets the game-winning goal against Cheap Hockey.
Okay, Eamon.
South Jersey Sugarbush are making a run here. Plugs against the Plugs. Kyle Kupervis. How do you say it? Kupervis. He scores 2 goals, 3 assists. Maddie Chernoff with 2 goals, 2 assists.
Oh, Maddie.
6-4 win for the Sugar Bush. They're making a push at the end.
Yes, and Plugs, 1 point in 2 games. Very, very detrimental.
Yes.
But at the still a very tight race.
All right. Last night,
the nail in the U crew coffin, huh?
It was. Glassboro Goop played the strategy for Stars. Stars needed 1 single point. To qualify for the playoffs, and they lose 7-2.
I think this is
one single point.
Yes. Did not work out. Big shout out to Mike Reynolds. Mike Reynolds fell into the boards, broke his collarbone, which stinks. I've done that before. Yeah. And hope you recover fast. Mike was an all-star. He was at the all-star game, played in the all-star game. Great player, bad, unfortunate situation.
Yeah, it sucks, man.
Just like, yeah, just kind of ran into the board shoulder first. Can't, just freak accident.
Mm-hmm.
As a member of the Stars, I can definitely relate. But, yeah.
Right. Same.
So, yeah, today is Friday, August 2nd, and we have a bunch of games tonight. Mm-hmm. I will go to the day. What is it? Today's the August 2nd?
Yep.
Jesus.
Today is August freaking 2nd.
Shaka's brah. Play Dad Bods at Hollydale Ice Arena 8:30. Chuggernauts play the Jersey Tropics. Invaders.
Yep.
Play the Narwhals.
I love the Invaders, dude.
Me too. More to come for that. Hawks Prawns play Jersey Shore Trash. Jerry's so jealous, dude. He's so jealous.
You're so stupid. You're stupid. Are you playing tonight?
No.
Why?
Huh?
I think we need players.
Hawks Prawns? We?
What do you mean we?
We?
Are you playing?
You've played two games all season.
I have not played two games.
You haven't made it in fucking a month and a half.
I don't know why you're yelling at me right now. You're being really rude.
No, he's not we.
Are you
playing? Hold on.
You got to earn the we.
I played seven games.
You did not.
I'm on the stat sheet. I'm seven. Seven games played.
That's fake. Not right. That's not real.
Not right.
Seven games, 4 points. Suck it. Yeah, let's go.
When was the last time you played?
Probably like
June. You got credited for games that you were not there.
Not
for.
True, dude. 100%. Listen, scorekeepers are on it, okay? So they wouldn't do that because right. We have employees that actually care. And all right, are
seven
amazing.
Games. Jerry.
So I've played seven games and I have 4 points. Steve, you only have four games played with 7 points. That's pretty good. So we're the opposite. 7-4, 4-7. Yeah, I'm just saying.
You're playing defense.
And you're playing defense, yeah.
All right.
So this is a good opportunity here. So preview Friday's games and the Rusty preview.
Let's go Invaders. Come on.
Yeah.
They're in, aren't they?
They need to win.
They need to win.
Okay. There's still a couple games left
Let's fucking go.
Yeah.
Two games left. All right, Larry, you going to do the standings?
I will. Yes. Did you want to do your Friday and
Can
Rusty?
Can you stop burping into the freaking mic?
Did you want to do your Friday and Rusty preview? Or
I do want to do Friday and Rusty. I did Friday already.
Okay.
That's for Rusty the Invaders.
Preview. Yeah.
So
and the Hawks.
Let's all go. Right. And yes, Rusty, for a you first.
Yeah, buddy.
We will be having our first games at the Igloo.
This is fun.
In Mount Laurel.
I've heard horror stories about the Igloo. Is it good?
Shut up, dude.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's fine. I play there every Friday.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, it's fine.
Okay.
They're getting it.
Dude, you know what I heard? I'm just going to say it. I heard concrete was coming through the ice.
Well, that happens at other rinks too.
Oh, really?
Yes. ones that we play at often.
It certainly does.
Okay, fair.
Yeah, not Flyers training.
I was just...
All right, so... Yes,
never played.
Voorhees is the best ice, I'm pretty positive.
Yeah.
Really?
Especially the Flyers rink, yeah. I love it the most, yeah. I never...
What'd you think of AC?
It was actually not that bad.
I didn't think AC
the was ice bad. Was good. It was like dark.
It was dark in there, yeah. They need a little bit better lighting, but...
ice is good, though.
Ice was good. Yeah, Flyers Training Center, they have the best ice, best lighting.
Completely level in all areas.
Yes, you're not going to fall into a corner,
exactly.
Zamboni door, snap your ankle, yes. All right. Anyway, South Jersey Corn Stars take on the South Jersey Raptors at the Igloo Mount Laurel. Dusty Beavers play the Yetis.
Yep.
I want to say something.
3 o'clock game. Look at that.
3 o'clock
game. I was about to say, we have some early games.
3 p.m. What a game. Sunday, 3 p.m., 4:30 is Dusty Beavers versus the Yetis.
Let's go.
Narwhals play Moose Hockey at 6 p.m. We actually have a little bit of a silver makeup game going on at Flyers Training Center at 7:25 p.m. Whale Watchers play Militia. Rusty Wolves play the Dusty Bush at Igloo Mount Laurel at 7:30. Rusty Wolves can still, man.
Headlining, man. So I have a question. Does Igloo have more than one rink, or is it just one rink there?
Two, the red rink and the blue rink.
Oh, red and blue. Oh,
which one's the better one?
You know? The one I play on is the one on the right-hand side. I don't know the difference between the two.
Sure, that's blue.
Well, these are all in the blue rink, so.
I'm not sure because the one on the right-hand side, the one on the left, they were recently like renovating or something like that and doing fixes and repairs too. So.
Gotcha.
Maybe that's a concrete.
Santora's playing at 3 p.m. It's going to be a weapon that day. It's going to be a menace.
He's going to be a menace.
Why? What's the difference?
Starting hockey early, man. It means he's going to be drinking beers early. Oh,
3 o'clock. That's fair.
He's going to be asleep by 7 p.m.
God. All right, shall we do some playoff preview predictions, those types of things?
Yeah, can we go over who we picked again?
Yes, actually. I'm glad you brought that up.
Nah.
So shall we do our original predictions here? Because Steve is so the three of us picked 24/7 for gold. We also picked Bulldogs for silver, all three of us. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Which in first place, Bulldogs, let's go.
Yeah. So good picks there. Mm-hmm. Well, to be determined in gold. But bronze plus, Steve went with Paisanos, who actually missed
the playoffs.
So. Bam, bam, bam. And then I went with Goop, who have a who are in the semifinal matchup as of now.
Not a bad pick.
Nope, not a bad pick. Jerry, however, went with the number one seed in bronze plus, Moonshine.
Let's go.
He had faith in the meatball.
Let's go, meatball.
Listen, everybody else in bronze plus going to get the sauce. Know what I mean?
Not for our bronze.
Give it to him, Edie.
Not for our bronze picks. Steve went with JMCC Auto. Nice, safe pick. I went with Chuggernauts, and Jerry also went with Chuggernauts.
Chugs. Okay. Hey, they're in third. Okay. Let's go. Chugs.
Now, Rusty Division, you guys both went with Corn Stars.
Yeah, they're good, man. Well, so here's the thing. We went Corn Stars when Leeds. Leeds was the goalie. He's good. But
that's cute. It's cute you guys did that.
To be fair.
They'll win.
Yeah, to be fair.
Double down.
Every game is close with them now. Did you notice?
Yeah.
But they're still winning.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
They still have a very good all-around team.
Right. Mm-hmm. So. Now, I went with Moose Hockey, so we'll see what happens there.
You're a big Moose guy.
I do like to pick the Moose.
Moose Nuckies. They're in there.
Yeah, hey, buddy. All right, so do you want to do a quick playoff preview breakdown? I have a couple notes here on different scenarios and things like that. If you want to open up the standings, or perhaps we should open up the schedule, see if there's any implications coming up next week.
Don't have it on TV
today,
Stevie.
Yeah, no TV, eh? Yeah. So in the gold division, obviously Rain City in 24/7.
Yep.
Have a matchup, and then Chill versus Night's Watch. So that's not going to change.
The matchups aren't going to change. No.
Playoff picture. So there
that's,
it is.
That's what we're looking at here. And then I, for one, I know I've said it plenty of times, but I will definitely be attending those games because I think it's going to be a lot of fun.
It is.
So, Silver Division, we have Bulldogs versus the Ducks right now. And then Rain City and Night's Watch in the Silver Division, 2-3 seed. Rain City jumped over Night's Watch, which it didn't change the matchup, but the teams are set in the Silver Division.
Teams are set, but the matchups aren't.
I mean, honestly, Rain City can jump over Blue Chew Bulldogs with a win at the end.
Yeah, but Malty Ducks can jump too.
They can jump too.
Yeah, so.
Malty Ducks can
get some seeding switch.
Malty Ducks can go all the way up to second.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Yeah.
They can go to first, honestly.
How?
Right? Because they have two games left. 16, 18 points. Oh. The number one seed is 17.
Yeah, you're right.
Things are going to be based on who's playing who in the last couple weeks, too. Mm-hmm. That's the thing.
It is.
So,
Malty Ducks play Rain City.
Mm. Ooh, that's tough.
Their last couple games, they play Rain City and Barracudas.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I'd assume that they're going to beat the Barracudas, but Rain City is going to, they're going for the one seed.
Yeah, they want the one seed.
They would get the one seed if they get the win. Rain City,
dude. Yeah, because Bulldogs are done. You're right.
Yeah, they have 12 games in.
Ooh. If ever there was a game of the week.
That's just the start of it, though. This is just the start of it. Because Bronze Plus, Bronze, and Rusty, or Bronze Plus and Bronze specifically, are very, very interesting.
So even Silver.
Well, the playoff teams are set in Bronze Plus.
And Bronze Plus are set, yeah.
Yes. But
so
seeding isn't.
Yeah, as of now, Moonshine has jumped into first, and they would play the winner of a play-in of Otters versus Knights. So
yeah, one, two, and three can switch.
Yeah.
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 Okay.
Pretty much.
So Otters, Goop is now facing off with the Thundercats, who dropped out of first place. Mm-hmm.
So whoever wins that game will be in second place.
Okay. They're playing each other?
Which is exciting.
Okay.
I believe, right? Isn't that what you just said? Goop and Thundercats?
Well, no, they're playing each other. This is the playoff preview. So,
if the season
ended today.
I got you. I thought you meant they're playing each other because that would have been awesome if they were.
Goop's last game is against the Koopas.
Okay.
And the Moonshine's last game is against the Thundercats.
Ooh. So I have a note that the top three seeds could change, though.
So Thundercats could leapfrog Moonshine
first
and
go to first. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's the game that.
It's a big win, but I'm going to be honest with you. When you have Moonshine, Goop, Thundercats, Otters, and Knights, nobody's safe.
Nah.
Whether if you get the one seed and you play the Otters, the Knights, not safe.
Exactly.
If you play Goop, you play Thundercats, like any of these five teams, I think, could win at any given night.
Yeah, I agree.
So it doesn't really matter.
I mean, 1-4 is separated by 2 points. So that's good.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Big goal differential for the top three seeds versus the fourth, but... in terms of goal scoring,
yeah,
and everything. But I still think like any given night they could win.
About to say, so doesn't matter. You just need one more that day.
Yes. We will be setting rosters and playoff eligibility. You should see that in your inbox. Grace will be monitoring rosters at every single game.
Yes.
So she will be going to every game, and Grace doesn't fuck around. Mm. You bring somebody that doesn't belong, she will kick you off.
She'll fight you.
She might pull you off by, you know.
By your ear.
By your ear, yeah.
Yeah, that,
for sure.
That's a mom thing.
That is a mom thing.
Yes.
And I think she's got that down.
She does.
So, all
right. So we had a lot of movement in the Browns division. Yes. The Tropics have jumped up to first. Dad Bouds will now be facing off against the Invaders, who've dropped down to seventh. The Plugs have been left out of the playoffs as of now.
Pluggies, come on.
And the Sugar Bush jump in to play against the Chuggernauts. Again, this is if it ended today.
Yes.
Okay, so again, that would be Tropics in first place, Dad Bouds versus the Invaders, Chugs versus Sugar Bush, and then the Warriors versus JMCC Auto. So
Invaders are going to get a couple wins to close out the season, and then
they're hanging on.
Be a lot different.
They're hanging on.
They'll be in the middle.
Can we look at that 4-5? That 4-5 seeding. I think Warriors, James, CC Auto, I think they're going to go. One of them.
Really?
I think so.
I could see the Warriors doing that.
Warriors, James, CC Auto went last year. So they have it in them.
It's a different division.
They have it
in them. It is. Crazy division.
Yeah.
So I think 4-5. 4-5 is the must watch.
Yeah. So funny enough, Rusty Division, Corn Stars are still in the lead. The play-in game, however, has switched to Yetis versus Shakas, where last week it was Narwhals versus Moose. So the Yetis and Shakas have dropped down below the Narwhals and the Moose. So
crazy.
Yeah, Yetis and Shakas are in the 4 and 5 seed. Narwhals and Moose would technically be the semis in the 3rd and
4th. Wolves still alive.
They are still alive.
In the hunt with less than, I don't even know how much percent chance they have.
Very little.
Very little.
But keep
going. They are technically in it.
Well, yeah, Shakas have to lose out and Wolves have to win out.
And
yes, and there's a huge goal differential change, but they are technically still in it.
Correct.
Okay.
I still love, look at the Beavers. We've come along. I'm just saying, hold on. Look at the differential.
Do we have to, dude?
Yeah, we do, because look at the differential. I know our record
is not bad.
Yeah, I know our record doesn't show it. We are a much better
team. You guys are at -4 now?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy.
We are a much better team at 3-7. I just don't think it does us justice of how far we've come and how well we've played this season.
Well, if you were to show up most of them, it might be different. But
the game I didn't show up, we won.
How many games didn't you show up for the Beavers?
I don't know.
All right. -34 was your goal differential last season. So, yes, you have improved greatly.
Is my point. That's a shout out to Big James. Let's go.
Most wins came when you weren't there. So
what? Why are you yelling at me? Hold on.
You made 7 out of 10 games. Yeah. So you're at a 70% clip.
That's pretty good.
Good job.
That's pretty good, he says. That is just sad.
What's the quote that you say? The best... what is it? Best ability is availability?
Yeah.
What is that? Is that what it is?
I just got that off like ESPN or something like that. But
that's stupid.
You know.
Best ability is availability.
You're stupid.
Yeah. Do you even...
Which a lot of people would argue that that's not exactly true.
Yeah, 7 games played.
Well, you don't have the most points per game, so...
No, but I'm up there.
Irrelevant.
Speaking of points per game, I just realized we're an hour in. That's our playoff preview. Let's do it real quick. Let's run through our predictions here. And then I need to shout out our players of the month, or at least the nominations, and then we can wrap it up here.
Let's go.
So what do we got here? I mentioned our predictions before. Let's start with gold.
Well, Rain City is going to play Team 24/7 in the semis. That's not a good matchup for Rain City Gold, assuming that Team 24/7 shows up, the entire team. If that was ever going to happen, I wanted that to be in the finals, but that's the semifinals.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Bless you.
You're a mess today, man.
Blessed art thou.
It's early. It's 1 o'clock, 1:30. All right, so I'm going to stick with 24/7 on this.
You're going to stick with 24/7. Jerry, do you have a prediction? Do you want to hear the matchups again?
I'm looking at it.
All right, let's go.
He's looking at his phone.
Dude. I'm sticking with my prediction.
24/7?
Yeah, sticking with him.
What now, are you saying? I'm going Rain City Gold.
Rain City Gold.
Sorry, I hate to be a chalk here, but...
Listen, in Huff I trust. Let's go.
See, yeah, I know. The thing with...
Yeah. Thing is, I don't even know if he really tries until the playoffs, dude.
That's my point.
He still drops like fucking
7 points a game.
So we all started with the Bulldogs and silver. Do we have a switch up here? Because this is
Bulldoggies.
Tough. Well, you know why I want the Bulldogs to win is because they've been around the most. I know a lot of the guys. I would like to see them win, but I also wouldn't mind seeing Multitux win, honestly.
Who's it going to be? Who do you think?
I'm going to stick with
Bulldogs. That's a first round matchup as of now.
That's a tough matchup, dude.
Listen, Blue Chew Bulldogs, it's going to be hard. But I'm sticking with them.
Yeah, I'm going to stick with them, too.
All right.
I think they're going to put it in.
Not to be different here.
Put in the work. They'll put it in real good. Shut up, Jerry. And what?
Not to be different here.
My prediction.
You said, oh, okay. I thought you were being a perv again.
I am.
Prediction.
Not to be different here. I'm going to go with Night's Watch.
Ooh. All right. Okay.
Always got to be different.
Always got to be different.
All right. Let's go.
But I like it, though.
Browns Plus. Who we got? As of now, Moonshine sitting in the
first seat. I'm sticking with mine because I picked them from the beginning, and now they're in first, so it's sitting pretty for me.
I'd like to see their playoff roster. Yeah. Sorry.
And I like the Saucy. Mr. Saucy himself.
I'm going to go with Moonshine. I'm going to take the easy one.
You guys just copying off each other?
We're legit taking every team.
I'm going with the Thundercats repeat.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Yeah, I was going to do that, and then
you were.
Alf ticks me off. So
yeah, but aren't the Otters buzzing right now?
No.
Fair enough. I thought they were.
They're not?
No, I thought they were doing all right.
All right, who you got for bronze here? Tropics in the first seed.
No, that's hard. As much as I want the Invaders to win, the odds of them...
I was about to say, they got a long way to go, man.
Are low. But to be a first-season franchise and be this close,
I definitely
see championships in their future. Maybe fall.
Let's go.
But Sugar Bush is really buzzing right now. It's all because we have quarterfinals in this one.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Man, I'm gonna go. Dad bods are really good too. I'm gonna go dad bods.
So am I.
I'm gonna go dad bods.
I'm going dad bods.
Wow, who did I pick?
What?
Who did I pick in the beginning? Do you have that?
Chugs.
I picked Chugs.
Yeah, you want Chugs.
Okay, so I want to stay true to what I said before. The 4-5. I want to switch it. I want to switch it to the Warriors.
Nice pick, Jerry.
Yeah.
Welcome to the U.
Thank you.
Let's go. Rusty, who we got?
I'm going to stick with the Corn Stars here.
The Corn Stars?
I don't know.
Jer, anyone?
Dusty Beavers. yeah, I'll stick with the Corn Stars. I think they're the best all-around team.
I'm going to stick with the Meese.
The Meese.
You love the Meese, dude. He does. I don't know if we have any Moose listeners.
I don't know either, but I'm a big Moose fan.
You're a big Moose fan.
Yeah, big Moose fan.
All right.
All right, real quick. July's player of the month. I have some nominations here, but I assume we'll be able to pick it after I throw them out here. So representing Rain City Gold, Jay Collin, 3 points per game. However, Rain City Gold stacked. Let's be honest. Yeah. A lot of people putting those points up. Matt Bidini on chill, 91.5 save percentage, 5 games played. Sicko.
How many wins?
That's a good question. 5 games played, though, with 91.5 save percentage. What more can he do? Whether they win or lose, what else can he do? You know what I mean? So, that is a good question. I don't have the team stats. But Silver, Matt Major on the Bulldogs, 4 points per game.
Nice.
AJ Colello on the Barracudas, 89.4 save percentage over 5 games played. I'm voting Matt Major there. And for the record, in the gold division, I'm going with Matt Bidini. Bronze Plus, and Chicatelli.
Can I say one thing really quickly, though?
Yes.
So Barracudas are 11 games played, only 3 wins, but the lowest goals against by far. So their goaltender is very good. So yes. They have they've allowed 48 goals. That's it. And the next best is 52.
I think we know firsthand their goalie is very good.
Yes. Yeah. So shout out to him. He's a good goalie.
Yeah, he is.
They only scored 41 goals. That's probably their downfall.
Yeah. So. Bronze Plus and Chicatelli.
He's been playing really well.
3 points per game, representing the Veritas Senators.
Chicatelli.
Yeah, both all-star, right?
Yes.
I believe he's an all-star.
And they've been winning. They lost one, but they won another one. But like, they score a lot of goals. Like they're top.
Yeah,
they're close to the top. They're at the bottom. This has kind of been a weird season, but like, Senators are last in the division, but like third in goal scored or fourth in goal scored.
Fourth, yeah,
right. Yeah. So, you know, and he's been playing well for, he plays with Invaders as well.
Oh, he's on the Invaders. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. All right. So, shout out to Dave Van Horn on the Otters, 92.9 save percentage, only two games played, but still sick. Bronze division, Tim Harding representing the Chuggernauts, 3.25 points per game. I will probably be giving it to him. Tyler Rogers, another honorable mention, 95.3 save percentage across two games. And then in the Rusty division,
let's hear it.
I have a couple of narwhals up top here.
Wow.
We've had a good month. So
Patrick.
I have Chris Gaskill, three points per game.
Sorry, I mixed up the
guys. That's okay. 3 points per game. And then I have Dave Sr. with a 93.1 save percentage over three games played.
Wow.
Which anything over 90 in my book is very good.
Yeah, narwhal's been buzzing.
Gnarly.
Two losses. So my question is, Matt Major or AJ Colello?
Because
you seem to have a lot of love for the Barracuda's goalie.
Dude, I mean,
he made a good point, actually.
Very good point.
If we're talking like, I mean, they don't get a lot of wins, so it's tough to say.
See, but
like, it's not his.
What else can he do? You know,
he puts we're talking the most up. Valuable player.
Yeah,
I'd say that it would.
But we're talking player of the month.
How many wins did Bulldogs get in the mat in July?
Probably a lot, but they also probably had a lot of players who contributed, you know. So
they had a lot of games in July. So they had two, three wins, but one was a forfeit. So you know, I'm gonna say AJ.
Okay.
Yeah.
Shout out to Colella on the Barracudas. So we got two goalies here. You think how do you guys feel about the Narwhals? Gaskill or Dave Sr.?
Gaskill.
Yeah, good player. Cool. So I'm going to go congrats to Chris Gaskill on the Narwhals, Tim Harding on the Chuggernauts, and Chicatelli on the Veritas Senators, AJ Colella on the Barracudas, Matthew Idini on Team Chill, players of the month for July.
Beautiful.
Right. July 2020. All right. Yeah, let's wrap it up here. I don't know if you have any commissioner's notes or anything you want to say to the people.
No.
I just want to shout out really quickly all of our commenters. A lot of love again on with John being on the podcast.
Frankie
James throwing out a bunch of comments in the last episode.
He was hyped for that All-Star game and that shootout.
And shout out to Christian Davidson, who wasn't at the All-Star game because he was celebrating his 17th anniversary in Poconos.
Nice.
Happy anniversary, CD.
Yeah, happy anniversary. And that is
it.
All I got, boys.
All right.
All righty.
Beautiful.
Love you guys.
It's been real. It's been fun.
All right.
Adios.
See you guys.
Peace. Right. Bye.